tinkerers, it's catapult day, and a catapult attack can come from anywhere. Look to the skies!
It's Tinkertime.
Hey tinkerers, today we're going to be making catapults, and it's going to be awesome. So the catapult was quite an ancient invention. It was used in war times and battles to throw things really long distances. But we've also used the catapult invention to get planes flying through the air, hang gliders, slingshots. It's a really similar science. So today we're going to be making really simple catapults that you can do at home with all the stuff that you've already got surrounding you. Now the first catapult is made from none other than a cardboard roll and a wooden spoon. So I thought about using a toilet roll, which you absolutely could, but when you kind of started applying pressure onto the toilet roll, it was a bit bendier. So then I found these kind of paper towel rolls, and it was much stronger. It was one long one, and then I cut it up into three pieces. So you see, what I've done is I've added three cardboard rolls together, and then a wooden spoon off the edge. And then we've just rubber banded that on to make this slingshot. Now you watch here. Oh, that is a nice flicking action. So let's test this puppy out. One tomato. One, two, three, fire in the hole! Oh, caught it in the spoon!
Fire in the hole!
Woo! And off it goes. That tomato went a pretty good distance. So last week on Show Me Your Guts, we opened up an LED alarm clock to see what was inside. And this is what we found. Oh, that's annoying. But rather than throw all that e-waste into the bin, we decided to make some creations. So we figured out we had Jay's hot dog stand.
Ooh, hi, my name's Steve and I'd love a hot dog. Oh, dude, well, we got dogs. Oh, okay, well, I guess I'll have, I think, oh man, I fell down. I got a full banana. Okay, well, I'm gonna have a dog with a lot. Okay, dude, coming right up, $5.
Oh, really, I'm really hungry. I wonder if I can get a salad over here. Oh, hi. I'd like a salad.
A what?
A salad.
Oh, dude, we don't do salads. We do dogs, you know.
Okay, I'll have a salad dog.
No, dude, that's not a thing.
So you don't have any salad?
No. I got a tofu dog.
Tofu dog. Oh, I kind of want a salad.
Sorry, dude, only dogs.
Okay, well, I guess I'll try the tofu dog then.
Okay, dude, coming right up. $5.
The Lego catapult.
So basically what I did was take some simple Lego, a basic wheels, and then attached to the bottom. And because I had this claw, I thought he would be awesome for being the cup. But otherwise, you could just make a bit of a square. Super simple. This is more of a grape-sized Lego. Now, the really important thing to work out here, tinkerers, is where you place these wheels makes a huge difference to how far your catapult will throw. So I'm going to start them with about midway back here. Let's put the grape inside the catapult. Here she comes.
Woo!
Oh man, that got some serious distance. Lost my thing. Let's check out that bigger angle again. Move it back this way. Oh, now we're talking. That's an angle. All right, let's chuck this grape in here one more time. One, two, three.
Fire in the hole! Whoa!
Oh, that was a long, low throw, that one. All right, now I've got my superior Lego creation here, catapult. Now these wheels, man, they're off a car set that I had and they are just ginormous. Gotta know this, the little horns on the end of the wheels. All that, the extra effect. Now because these wheels are much bigger, we've got a much bigger angle to be playing with our catapult throw. Are you ready? One, two, three, fire in the hole! That was kind of a little throw. Let's try it with a tomato. Tomato, in you go. Don't be juicy now. One, two, three, fire in the
The pencil catapult!
Now our last catapult, I decided to make out of pencils, rubber bands, and a spoon. And he's got a pretty good little flicking device there. He's kind of hopping across the table. Ribbit, ribbit. Stay still. Now just to really put myself to the challenge, what I thought I'd try and do is make this guy super fast. On your marks. Get set. And go! Go, Nene. Okay, I'm gonna take the ones that are kind of the same length here. All right, one and two. Make a cross there. Take that angle there. All right, this one is going on top of both pencils. And we're semi-solid there. All right, now take these three pencils and I want to put them together. Okay, they should be the same length. It would be much easier if they were the same length. On top, like this, like this. This is dodgier than my last one, I'll tell you that. Okay, now I've got my big spoony guy here. Place him on the outside. Faster, Nene. And we did it, finish.
Oh, the crowd goes wild.
It's ticket time. Okay, got my two catapults. One that I made with a bit of time up my sleeve, and one that I just made then. I don't know how long it took me, but it was great. Hey, come off there. Okay, we got two catapults here. We could double back. Okay, tomato. In. A bit wonky. That's because the three pencils weren't the same length. Dodgy style. Here, can you hold that tomato spoon?
Yes.
Okay, good work. On the count of three. One, two, three. That was the worst catapult ever. Back to the catapult drawing board, tinkerers. We got a tofu dog, if that's your thing.
One, two, three.
Oh no, dude, he lost an eye. Okay, cut. Dude lost his eye.
Oh, I lost my eye.